Just wanted to say thanks for all the views on the winger breakout skills video. This one should tie it together. This is breakout skills for defensemen. So generally we talk about five main breakout options or skills a defenseman should know, and that's the quick up, the over, the wheel, the reverse, and rim. There's more than that, of course, but those are just the five main ones. And we could go into that in much deeper detail, but I don't want to get these much more than 10 or 15 minutes. So we'll go through it here and try to cover off a bunch of information just within these videos. So the first one is just quick up. Ottawa player here goes back and picks up that puck and just turns it up ice and gets it going. So gets back to the puck, shoulder check, surrounds it, gets it going up ice. The one thing we want to just touch on with that is retrieval speed. In practice, in the games, make sure your defensemen are going back hard for the puck, looking over their shoulder and trying to minimize the time. By getting back quick, they can get it turned and get going up ice a lot quicker. If your defensemen are just gliding back for the puck, that's something you should address and get them sprinting back for it. Second one is over. This one has actually a really good clip. It starts with the goalie stopping a puck and passing it to his defenseman. And that's a really good way to start drills or incorporate that into some of your drills you're running. Have a coach dump a puck in so the goalie has to stop it and make a pass to the defenseman or to the winger or center, whatever you want to do with it. Just gets the goalies incorporated and gets them some reps on stopping rim pucks and getting their eyes up and moving that puck to an area. So this one kind of starts with a lot of good components in it. But it's generally just, you see a lot more banks just because guys are playing their strong side. This one, it's a backhand bank to the partner, and this one he goes to the centerman. So off of a D-to-D over, you can hit centerman, you can hit winger, whatever. Doesn't matter, as long as your forwards know the pattern and the routes, and that's something to work on in practice too. Not that you want to be practicing the breakout all the time, you want to be practicing components of it. So you can just work with defensemen working on hitting that center swing so they can get their timing right, different things like that. And then the wheel. There's quite a bit involved in the wheel. Only going to touch on some of it, but a defenseman again has to sprint back to that puck, read pressure, know who's coming, and make a decision from there. So going up the middle, I know there's some coaches that, again, some old school guys never want a player skating up the middle. You got to read it, whether you have pressure or not. Here Keith has no pressure and he just gets to the middle of the ice. And what's beneficial about being in the middle of the ice is you have numerous passing lanes depending on where your players are. So if you were over on the boards, you have to pass back across traffic and through the middle, which is usually when pucks get picked off and taken away. So I always try to get the young defensemen to, when they go down to retrieve a puck, try to take a read on what kind of pressure they have and where the lanes are open, and if they have the ability to come up between the dots, and it just gives them more puck passing options. Not always the case, so you have to take what's available. On a wheel, if you have pressure on you, you got to go find the holes and get moving with it. So this is an example of that. This one, he's got tight pressure on him, he's got a checker right on him. If that checker follows you behind the net, that's usually a good time to put it in gear and go for a wheel. So he gets outside the dots and goes right down the wall based on pressure. Then go into the reverse. So you can see here, he's got his head on a swivel. He's looking across, seeing where his partner is, making a read, checking who's behind him. Nice little reverse into an area. So reverse, fairly simple. So this one's a rim. Player just gets that puck, sees he has pressure on him, throws it all the way around, and then winger comes down and makes a play on it. And that's what transitions directly into the winger skills video that I have on the channel too. Those two things coming together in order to get pucks out under pressure. And rule of thumb too is keep the puck moving don't change directions of it. So if your forwards know that when defensemen have a bunch of pressure on them, they can't make a play with it, that the puck is just going to continue the way that it's actually going. So this one, Phillips chases this puck down and just keeps it moving. It's easier to keep that puck moving the direction it's going than switching directions of it. One more I'm just going to add in here too is just off the breakout using the weak side defenseman. So in this one, I think it's number four here. So the puck is in a scrum. Chicago gets control of it, and number four is activated and going up ice. He's already in the mentality to be part of the rush right from net front. The player that's checking him is down here. So when you think about numbers, offensive numbers going down the ice, this is where the defensemen really need to be aware how to get into the play right from the front of their net. Puck comes across, just joins the rush. Another example of it here. And one thing to watch and keep an eye on here is always having a target and always being ready for the puck. A lot of young players in this position would be skating with their stick about waist height and not in an athletic position ready to catch that puck or be an option. Always being an option for defensemen on the breakout is absolutely crucial. How many options that this player has with the puck just absolutely makes a breakout much easier, where this is about the one guy that isn't an option right here. But if he swings into an area where he's an option, players without the puck always have to be moving and ready to receive that pass. So it goes up to the winger, back to the weak side D in net front, and really good breakout. So hopefully that paints a picture of some of the skills that the D are using on the breakout. And like I said earlier, don't concentrate too much on the whole picture of the breakout. Break it down into little chunks so defensemen and wingers get higher reps of plays that are representative to the game. So whether a defenseman starting a shooting drill where the defenseman just has to skate in from the ringette line, pick up a puck and hit the centerman, or pick up the winger and then join anything. Just be creative with your drill making so it's high reps. A lot of coaches just will dump a puck in behind the net. Three forwards, two defensemen will go back and do one breakout and skate all the way down the ice and take a shot, and then they don't get another rep for, 2 minutes while the other groups go. So just concentrate on doing station work and getting high reps of those the parts of the breakout, not just the whole of the breakout. I hope that helps.